Okay, we're here getting our buddy Mike. Mike, say hi.
How you doing?
Mike's ZX-10 ready for the track. One of the things we were going to do is install our clutch mod. We found some damaged plates. We're not going to go over it. You've seen it a million times, but Mike had about had three smeared plates. How many passes did you make before now?
Maybe 10.
Maybe 10. 11. So, we don't have Kawasaki plates, so thank you, Suzuki. Said it a million times. Your bike doesn't know what the spelling on the part is. If it fits, it's the right size, shape, it'll work just fine. So that's what we're gonna do. One of the things I wanted to point out to you though, same old deal. This is the same stuff, but it's different. When we pulled Mike's clutch apart, we had debris inside the outer basket, which told us that these plates that were more towards the outside had seen quite a bit of heat. Now, this is a little bit different. This is where the slipper is on these, and you can see the slip, which is great if you're road racing. You downshift, that moves, the tire doesn't chirp, and your life is just cool. If you're drag racing, it knocks around. So we have a cool little part that just goes in and basically locks this down so it doesn't allow it to move. Now it's the same as the GSXR. They're all the same. They may be slightly different. So we're gonna put this thing back together. We're gonna add some additional spring pressure to help Mike keep his clutch life in longer. And we're also gonna be putting in Allison less than zero in Petron and hopefully making it to the track. We've got hour and a half. Yeah, we're cutting it close. So anyway, hopefully we'll see you at the track next time we see you.
Chevrolet S10 Creekside. Staying up here.
To get rolling,
maybe second too. Gotta make up for it on the big end.
Whoever tried to snap it to get it rolling.
It'll be better.
Sometimes that works well.
I'll hold on there.
Have you ever been to the track and just not had a good day? Look at all the green underneath this motorcycle. That's a sure sign that you didn't have a good day at the racetrack. So, we're going to turn this into a learning moment, because I know what happened. It's very simple. Human error, right? We ran through and passed our typical structure. We didn't do the things that we've been perfecting for years. And as a result, we didn't catch a problem on this bike. Thank goodness, bike's not scratched. More, thank goodness, the rider's not scratched. So basically what we're gonna do, we're gonna pull this thing out of the trailer here, let you see what went on, and then Mike did have one good pass last night, and we didn't get back from the track till late. Mike lives about 300 miles away, so he went home. We're fixing this, and then I'm going to hand deliver his repaired motorcycle to him myself, because he was supposed to pick it up, and he was gracious enough to let us use it for our program. So definitely the least I can do is get him all fixed up and make sure everything's okay. And then we're going to incorporate some changes that he wanted to see. That can help him go fast. He ran a 929 on a really smooth, just basically a test pass, and went 158 miles an hour. This bike's making great power. Yet again, now it's a matter of getting the bike to work how the rider likes it. I have my own setups that I've used for years, but Mike requested a couple different things, and we'll let you know what those are. And then we'll get him his bike, and hopefully our track is basically, it's not closed for the season, but it's closed for the season when combined with our schedule. So we'll get the bike to Mike, let him go down the track, and see what he ends up with. But first things first, we have a sticky, gooey mess of antifreeze to clean up, all over the trailer, all under the bike, and of course we'll have to make sure that the engine's okay. I'm sure it is, but it didn't run very long when it was having its problems. So anyway, we'll see in a bit when we get this thing up on the lift. Leaving a trail of sticky, gooey mess. Alright. Can you see down in there? We are pulling this hose backwards. Alright, that should do it. Alright, come on over here if you would. So here's our culprit. As you can see, there's a hole right here where it burst. Now, why did it burst? It looks like something has rubbed against it. In all reality, that is a burn. So why would this be burned? If you look at where it goes, it's quite a ways away from the pentacarbon pipe, the standard underfairing pipe. So we used our investigative noggins when we were doing our sidewinder testing. Looky there, a burn spot on the back of the sidewinder that matches perfectly with the burn spot in the hose. So this is all our bad. We should have spotted that. I mentioned it before, I'm not making excuses. We were in a hurry. We didn't do our due diligence, and as a result, we've got a sticky mess that we've got to clean up. Scary situation, and Mike really only got to make one pass. His first pass was aborted because we didn't have enough fuel in the tank. We didn't want to put too much. If you put too little, the bike will surge, so he got rid of that pass. He made his next pass. You can see here, 929, 158.7, 620 in the eighth mile, 425 in the 330. Absolutely no doubt that this is an 8-second motorcycle with Mike at the controls. We're just gonna have to make everything work well for him. So that's actually a really, really good pass. And then the third pass, this happened. So Mike only got one pass on his bike, had to go back home. We're gonna get him all fixed up, deliver his bike to him. Like I said, we're gonna make a couple changes that he wanted in the gearing and in the clutch, just little slight things. We'll clean all this up. We've already got a new hose on order, and hopefully, we love Ohio. We love the seasons that, you know, some parts of the country don't have. The problem with the seasons are, it brings cold weather, it brings bad weather, and they shut our tracks down. So Mike's gonna try and squeak a couple track days in at his local, or tune and test sessions at his local drag strip. He's also, he road races, so he'll be picking this bike up. We got it slammed right now, and he'll be doing some track days. So we'll keep you guys abreast of what's going on. Hey, sometimes everything works, sometimes it doesn't. We'll give you both sides of the coin and show you that we messed up here real bad. So Mike took it well. We're happy. He's happy. He'll be happier when he gets his bike back. Until next time, I'm Brock from Brock's Performance. We'll see you then.